Welcome back to Akshara Online Classes, IIT and NEET Foundation. Myself, John Sir, your biology teacher. Today we will discuss about that the fundamental unit of the life. You know very well, in our surroundings, living things are present. What are the living things are present in our surroundings?
Plants and
animals. These are the plants and animals are made up of what?
Bacteria.
So that is in our surroundings, plants and animals and bacteria is present. That plants and animals are the living things. Yes or no? So biology is a branch of science. It deals with the living things. Yes or no? So that biology word derived from what? Greek language. Biology word derived from the Greek language.
Bio means life.
Logos means study. Biology study of the living things. Biology study of the living things, especially for the plants, animals, and microorganisms and human beings. Okay, next. So, who is the father of the biology? 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 Who is the father of the biology?
Sir, can I?
Tell me, why not?
Aristotle.
Very good. Aristotle is the father of the biology. Okay. Aristotle is the father of the biology. Especially these are the plants and animals made up of what? Plants and animals are made up of what? Cells. Plants and animals are made up of cells. Plants and animals are made up of cells. Okay. So especially cells. So these most of the living things like plants and animals are made up of cells. Okay. So all the living organisms are made up of cells. All the living organisms are made up of cells. Okay. So that's why cell is the cell. Cell is the basic unit of the life. Cell is the basic unit of the life. Cell is the fundamental unit of the life. Cell is the structural and functional unit of the life. Okay. Cell is the building blocks of the living organism. Yes or no? This cell was discovered by whom?
Antony von Leeuwenhoek.
Wow, wrong answer. Cell was discovered by the Robert Hooke, no? Robert? Actually, that observed with the help of the microorganisms was observed by the Antony van Leeuwenhoek. Okay. But later, that microscope was discovered by the Antony van Leeuwenhoek. But cell was discovered by the Robert Hooke in 1665. Okay. So when he was observed the cell, so honeycomb like structures are present. This each honeycomb like structures he was given to the name as a cell. Okay. This cell was derived from the Latin language. In that cell means little room. Okay. So this is called cell. Okay. Inside the cell, that center of the cell, this is called nucleus. Okay. Next. So what are the semi-solid homogeneous material is present? That is called cell membrane. Okay. Next. So actually a generalized cell consists of the three important parts. So that is first one is the cell membrane, cell membrane, cell membrane. Okay, next one is the cytoplasm. Cytoplasm. Third one is the nucleus. A generalized cell consists of the three important parts, that is called cell membrane, cytoplasm, nucleus. Now we can discuss about the cell membrane. What is that? Cell membrane. So in the cell membrane, also called plasma membrane. So you know very well. Okay, what is the outermost layer of the plant cell?
Cell wall.
Very good. Outermost layer of that plant cell is the cell wall. In the animal, the outermost layer is called cell membrane or plasma membrane. Cell membrane or plasma membrane. The outermost, here my point is, so in that animals, Almost all the animals, that outermost layer is called cell membrane or plasma membrane. This plasma membrane and cell membrane is made up of proteins and lipids. Proteins and lipids. Yes or no? Proteins and lipids. And cell membrane or plasma membrane is the outermost layer of the animal cell. This plasma membrane and cell membrane is made up of proteins and lipids. And this cell membrane and plasma membrane is the exit in and out of the cell. Are you catch my point?
Okay.
Next. So in that cell membrane also known as the selectively permeable membrane. What it?
Yes, sir.
Cell membrane also known as the selectively permeable membrane. What is the meaning of the selectively permeable membrane means? That cell which are required, that allows to that through the plasma membrane or cell membrane. Which are not required, that they can send outside through the plasma membrane or cell membrane only. So that's why plasma membrane also known as the selectively permeable membrane. Selectively permeability. Are you understand?
Yes, sir.
Next, if you see the plant cell, what is the outermost layer?
Cell wall.
Very good. Cell wall is the outermost layer of the plant cell. This cell wall is made up of what? Cellulose. This cell wall is made up of cellulose, hemicellulose, suberin, pectin, that is not required. Here my point is cell wall is made up of cellulose. And another important point is this cell wall giving to that size of the cell, structure of the cell, shape of the cell, and function of the cell. Yes or no? This cell wall giving to the shape of the cell, size of the cell, structure of the cell, and function of the cell. So now, after that, so in that plant cell, what is the outermost layer?
Cell wall.
In the animal cell, what is the outermost layer?
Cell membrane.
Very good. So, cell membrane. What is the another name of the cell membrane?
Plasma membrane.
cell membrane is made up of what?
Lipids and protein.
Cell wall is made up of what?
Cellulose.
Cellulose. Okay. So in the plant cell, which of that giving to the sufficient, so which of that giving to the structure of the cell? In the plant cell, who are giving to the shape of that organism and size of the organism and structure of the organism? Cell wall. Okay, in the animal, cell membrane is given to the shape, size, structure and function. Inside the cell membrane or inside the cell wall, homogeneous, semi-solid, okay, homogeneous, semi-solid, transparent material is present. That homogeneous, semi-solid material is called cytoplasm. What it is?
Cytoplasm.
Okay. So inside the cytoplasm, okay, so actually you know very well, cell organelles. Cell organelles means especially the little organs. The little organs means which of the cell is giving to the definite shape, definite structure, definite function is called cell organelle. These are the, in the cytoplasm, all the cell organelles are present. All the cell organelles are present. Okay, now we can discuss about that. Okay, so animal cell, so for example, this is called cell membrane. In the cell membrane, in that semi-solid homogeneous material is called cytoplasm. In the cytoplasm, all the organelles are arranged in the cytoplasm of the cell. Yes or no? In that, okay, a cell consists of three important parts, no? One is the cell membrane or plasma membrane or cell wall. Second one is the cytoplasm. Third one is the nucleus. What it is? Nucleus. Nucleus is the center of the cell. In that nucleus, that nucleus was discovered by whom?
Robert Brown.
Which year? 1831. Cell was discovered by whom? Robert Hooke, 1665. Okay, so nucleus. Nucleus is the double membrane structure. How many membranes is present there?
Two.
This is the outer membrane. This is the inner membrane. So, what is the membrane is present in that nucleus? That is called nucleus membrane. Nucleus membrane. Okay, this nucleus membrane, generally you can see porous. You can see that nucleus membrane is the double membrane structure. So that means, what is the cytoplasm? What are the semi-solid homogeneous material is entered into the nucleus? What are the material is present in that nucleus? That is also entered freely, they are moving in that cytoplasm. Okay. So, in that nucleus, actually four important parts are present. First one is the nuclear membrane. Nuclear membrane is the double membrane. न्यूक्लियर मेम्ब्रेन इज द डबल मेम्ब्रेन. आउटर मोस्ट लेयर ऑफ द न्यूक्लियस इज कॉल्ड न्यूक्लियर मेम्ब्रेन. दिस इज द पोरस that is allows to the substances to the cytoplasm to the nucleoplasm. Okay, next, especially in that eukaryotic organism, that nuclear membrane is present. In the prokaryotic organism, that nuclear membrane is absent. So this is the main difference between that prokaryotic and eukaryotic organisms. Okay, now coming to the point, in that inside that nuclear membrane, what are the homogeneous semi-solid homogeneous material? Nucleoplasm. What it is called? Nucleoplasm. In that cell, that is present cytoplasm. Inside the nucleus, that is called nucleoplasm. In that nucleoplasm, generally semi-solid homogeneous material, DNA and RNA, glycoprotein, these are all are present in the nucleoplasm. So second part is the nucleoplasm. Next, you can see that so inside the nucleoplasm thread like structures are present, that is called so that chromatin material is present. In that chromatin chromosomes are present. In that chromosomes genes are present. Genes are the responsible for the character of the organism. Okay, so third point is chromatin. What is that? Chromatin. In that chromatin means in that nucleoplasm, in the nucleoplasm thread-like structures are present. That thread-like structures are called chromatin. In that chromatin chromosomes are present. Like in that chromosome genes are present. That genes are the responsible for the character. Genes are the responsible for the character. Okay, for example, you are look like your parents, you are look like your father, you are look like your mother, because these are the characters are transferred to the parent, to the progeny through the chromosomes only. In the human being, how many chromosomes are present?
46
chromosomes are present. 23 pairs of the chromosomes are present. Okay, in that branch of science, in that genetics, we can study that transfer what studies of the genes and variations we can study. So next, one more part, generally in that chromatin, in that one more ball-like structure is present. That one more ball-like structure is called nucleolus. Nucleolus. This nucleolus is helped in the cell division. Okay, helped in the cell division. This is also formed especially in that this nucleolus helped in the cell division. This nucleolus also helped in the formation of that endoplasmic reticulum. This is about the internal structure of the nucleus. So a cell consists of the three important parts, that is called cell membrane or plasma membrane, cytoplasm, and third one is the nucleus. Now we can discuss about that. Different organs inside the cell. In that organelle, what are the organelles are present, we can study. So here, cell membrane. Each cell is surrounded by a cell membrane or plasma membrane. The cell membrane has the fine force through which substances may enter and leave out the cell through the cell membrane or plasma membrane. That cell membrane is made up of lipoproteins. Okay, so the actually semi-permeable membrane means the permeability of the cell membrane is selective. That means it allows only certain substances to pass through inside the cell. So that's why this is called selective permeable membrane. In the plant cell, you can see that cell have a cell wall surrounding the cell membrane. The cell wall is made up of cellulose. This cellulose is the non-living substances. This cell wall is giving to the shape and certain degrees of the rigidity of the cell without interfering with the functions of the cell membrane. Okay, so here this is about that plant cell and animal cell. In that plant cell and animal cell, actually nucleus is present, nucleus is present. Golgi bodies are present, Golgi bodies are present. Nucleus, smooth endoplasmic reticulum, rough endoplasmic, both are present, both are present. Chloroplast is present in that plant cell, chloroplast is absent in the animal cell. Cytoplasm is present, cytoplasm is present. Mitochondria are present in that plant cell. And vacuoles are present in the plant cell, vacuoles are absent in the animal cell. Okay, so vacuoles are absent in the animal cell. Next, cell membrane is present in that plant cell. Generally, cell wall is present in the animal cell. Cell membrane or plasma membrane is present. Okay, now cytoplasm. What we can say that cytoplasm, semi-solid homogeneous material is present inside the cell. That is called cytoplasm. So many here very important point is living cytoplasm is so many chemical reactions are takes place in the cytoplasm. Many chemical reaction, almost all the chemical reactions takes place in the cytoplasm only. Now we can discuss about that endoplasmic reticulum. What it is? Endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum, you can see here two types of the endoplasmic reticulums are present. One is the rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Yes or no? So here endoplasmic reticulum outside membrane is connected with the plasma membrane or cell membrane. Inner membrane they can connect it to the nuclear membrane. That is keep in your mind. Okay, outer membrane is connected, outer endoplasmic reticulum is connected with the cell membrane, inner membrane is connected with the nuclear membrane. Okay, in that two types of the endoplasmic reticulums are present, rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Rough endoplasmic reticulum means what are the granules are present, what are the ribosomes are present in that endoplasmic reticulum, that is called rough endoplasmic reticulum. What are the granules are absent, that is called ribosomes are absent, that is called smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Rough endoplasmic reticulum helped in the synthesis of the proteins. And smooth endoplasmic reticulum, synthesis of the fats.
Yes, sir.
Synthesis of the fats. So these are the proteins and lipids are helped in the formation of that plasma membrane or cell membrane. And here this point also, membrane biogenesis. What is the membrane biogenesis? So these are the rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum help to the synthesis of the proteins and lipids, proteins and fat. So that's why this endoplasmic reticulum is doing to the membrane of the biogenesis. Which of the organelles are associated with that membrane biogenesis?
Smooth endoplasmic reticulum.
Most of them, you can write it biogenesis, both are the endoplasmic reticulum. If they are giving to that rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum, you can give the answer to the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Are you clear about the endoplasmic reticulum?
Yes, sir.
Next, coming to the point, you know very well, mitochondria. Do you know?
Mitochondria.
So mitochondria generally we can see only through the eukaryotic organisms. Prokaryotic, most of that mitochondria are absent. Instead of the mitochondria, mesosomes are present. Okay. So these are the mitochondria also double membrane structure. Okay. So here my point is, potential energy converted into the kinetic energy through the mitochondria. Especially food is oxidized in the mitochondria. Mitochondria was discovered by the Kolliker. What is scientist name? Kolliker. So Altman given to the names to the bioplast. After that, Benda given to the name to the mitochondria. Kolliker discovered the mitochondria. This Altman given to the name to the mitochondria bioplast, and Benda given to the name to the mitochondria name. Almost all eukaryotic organism that mitochondria is present. This mitochondria is the rod shape or spherical in the shape. So this mitochondria is the double membrane structure. So this is called outer membrane. This is called inner membrane. Okay. So this is total arranged in where? In the cell. Yes? In the cell.
Its name is Altman, sir. What is its name, sir?
Kolliker discovered that mitochondria. Kolliker discovered the mitochondria.
Next one, sir.
Altman given to the name to the bioplast.
Yes, sir.
Benda name given to the mitochondria.
Yes, sir.
Kinetic energy converted into the potential energy converted into the kinetic energy. Potential energy converted into the kinetic energy. Okay. So respiratory organ in the plant is the mitochondria. Mitochondria also known as the powerhouses of the cell. Okay, that energy stored in the form of ATP. ATP full form is the adenosine triphosphate. Adenosine triphosphate. ATP also known as the energy currency of the cell. Energy currency of the cell. Okay, mitochondria is the rod shaped structure. Mitochondria is the double membrane structure. Mitochondria are present almost all the eukaryotic cells. Okay, you can see that in that inner membrane, homogeneous semi solid material is present. That is called
matrix.
That is called matrix. Matrix. So here in the matrix, so folded like structures are present.
Cristae
of the mitochondria. Cristae of the mitochondria. Here in that, especially in that plant respiration, three stages are present. First one is the glycolysis. What it is? Glycolysis. Second one is the Krebs cycle. Okay. थर्ड वन इज द इलेक्ट्रॉन ट्रांसपोर्ट सिस्टम. Electron transport system. Glycolysis occurs in the cytoplasm of the cell. Where it is occurred glycolysis? Glycolysis at cytoplasm of the cell. Krebs cycle is occur where? Matrix of the mitochondria. Matrix of the mitochondria. Next, electron transport is occurred in the crystal of the mitochondria. Crystal of the mitochondria. That energy is stored in the form of crystal, that food particle like F1 particles are present. In that F1 particle, this especially that ATP is present. So that's why mitochondria is also known as the power houses of the cell. Are you understand?
Sir, can you repeat the full form of ATP?
ATP. Adenosine. Adenosine triphosphate. Phosphate. Okay. This ATP also known as the energy currency. Currency of the cell. Of the cell. Energy currency of the cell. ATP also known as the energy currency of the cell. So here in that respiration. Okay. Respiration. Three steps are present. First one is the glycolysis. Where it is occur? Cytoplasm of the cell. Second one, what? Krebs cycle occur. Matrix of the mitochondria. Okay. Next, third one is the electron transport. Electron transport system. Okay.
These are the respiration processes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Electron transport system occurs in crystal of the mitochondria. Okay. Next, are you written?
Just a second, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Shall I continue?
Yes, sir.
Mitochondria also known as the
power
mitochondria, also known as power houses of the cell. So respiration occurs in the plant. Respiration occurs in the plants. Mitochondria. Mitochondria. Yes. Oxidation of the food is occurred in the mitochondria. So today what we have discussed? So actually what we have discussed means all the living organisms are made up of plants and animals. All the living organisms, all the living, especially is the biology is a branch of science, it deals with the living organism. These living organisms are made up of cells. So most probably plants and animals are the living organism. These plants and animals are made up of cell. Cell was discovered by the Robert Hooke in 1665. Plants are made up of cell, animals are made up of cell. So that's why cell is the fundamental unit of the organism. Cell is the basic unit of the organism. Cell is the structural and functional unit of the organism. Cell is the building blocks of the living organism. Yes or no? A cell consists of three main important parts, that is known as the cell membrane, cytoplasm, nucleus. Cell membrane, cytoplasm, nucleus. Able to audible, my voice is audible to you, Chandana?
Yes, sir.
Come. Okay, right. Plasma membrane, if you see the plant cell, the outermost layer is called cell wall. If you see the animal cell, that outermost layer is called cell membrane. Another name of the cell membrane is called plasma membrane. This cell membrane and plasma membrane is made up of proteins and lipids. Lipids and protein, or proteins and lipid, both are same. No confusion. Okay, proteins and lipid. So this cell membrane is the exit in and out. This cell membrane is the selectively permeable membrane. Which of the required to the cell, that is allowed, which is not required, that is sent outside. So that's why that is called selectively permeable membrane. Okay. So if you see the plant cell, outermost layer is called cell wall. This cell wall is made up of cellulose. This cell wall is giving to the shape and structure and function of the cell. Plasma membrane also giving to the shape of the cell, structure of the cell and function of the cell. Inside the cell, you can see the homogeneous, semi-solid, homogeneous, liquid, semi-solid liquid material is present. Almost all the chemical reactions, that means all the activities are occurs inside the cell, that is nothing but cytoplasm. That is called nothing but cytoplasm. If in the cytoplasm, cell organelles are present. What is the cell organelles means? Little organs. So which of the organs are giving to the definite shape, definite structure, definite function, that is called cell organelles. So inside the cytoplasm, cell organelles are present. Inside the cell, okay, so actually, so that first almost all center of the cell, that is called nucleus. Nucleus in that prokaryotic organism and eukaryotic organism, that most probably in the eukaryotic organism nucleus is present. In the prokaryotic organism nucleus is absent. Okay, in that nucleus four important parts are present: nuclear membrane, nucleoplasm, chromatin, nucleolus. Okay, almost outer membrane of that nucleus is called nuclear membrane, that is the porous, that is made up of, nuclear membrane is made up of glycoproteins.
lipoprotein inside the semi-solid homogeneous material is present, that is called nucleoplasm. DNA, genetic material, glycoprotein, all are present. So thread-like structures are present, is chromatin. In that chromatin, chromosomes are present. Chromosomes are the responsible for the character. Next, here one or two round ball-like structures are present inside that nucleoplasm, that is called nucleolus. Nucleolus helped in the cell division, that is formation of the endoplasmic reticulum. Nucleolus is very important. Next, second organelle is known as the mitochondria. Mitochondria also known as the power houses of the cell. Mitochondria, that energy stored in the form of ATP. ATP also known as the energy currency of the cell. In that mitochondria, almost all the eukaryotic organism, that mitochondria is present. This is the double membrane like structure. This is called outer membrane. This is called inner membrane. In the inner membrane, semi-solid homogeneous material is present. That homogeneous semi-solid material is called matrix. Next, in that folded like parts are present. These folded like parts is called cristae of the mitochondria. In the respiration, three stages are present. That is nothing but first one is the glycolysis, second one is the Krebs cycle, third one is the electron transport system. Okay, glycolysis is occurs in the cytoplasm of the cell, and Krebs cycle is occurs in that matrix of the mitochondria. Electron transport is occurs in the cristae of the mitochondria. ATP also known as the adenosine triphosphate. ATP also known as the energy currency of the cell. That energy is stored in the form of ATP. Okay, next, in that respiration, three stages are present. Three stages are present. They are glycolysis. Glycolysis occurs in the cytoplasm of the cell. Krebs cycle occurs in the matrix of the mitochondria. Electron transport system occurs in the cristae of the mitochondria. Okay, next, mitochondria is also known as the powerhouses of the cell. Respiration occurs in that plant, especially for the mitochondria. Are you understand? Any doubts? Please ask to me.
No doubts, sir.
Are you enjoyed the class?
Yes, sir.
It is good or bad?
Very good, sir.
Very good. We can please every Friday we have the class. Please come and attend the classes. Okay?
Yes,
thank you one and all. I can
thank
close
you,
the session.
Thank
right.
You, sir.
Right, Amma.